and welcome to NewsClick. The deletion of an essay by famous scholar A.K. Ramanujan from the history syllabus of the BA honours of Delhi University has created a controversy around the subject. On the one hand is the Academic Council of the University, which says that the essay hurts sentiments of a particular community. On the other hand, the history department has come out in open to support the essay, saying that it should not have been deleted. Today, we are joined by Dr. Biswamoy, Pati, Associate Professor in the History Department of Delhi University, to talk about the issue. Welcome to the show, sir. So, what were the circumstances that led to this kind of a situation where, on the one hand, the essay has been deleted, on the other, the History Department does not agree with this?
You see, this goes back in time to about 3 years or so, when the exact dates, etc., I don't remember because I had not joined the department at that time. What had happened one day was that suddenly, so we'll call them goons, let's say, of the ABPP, they landed up and, our head at that time, history department head, was Professor Jaffrey. And they shouted slogans, so people were pushed around, some glass panes were smashed. And the whole idea was that this is an offensive text and all that. And then apparently somebody filed a writ petition or something like that. Supreme Court gave a direction to the university, asking the university to sort of ask four experts to sit on judgment and say whether this text needs to be deleted or is it okay. Incidentally, this is now not a part of the BA Honours History program or whatever we call it. This is something which is called a concurrent course, which people from other disciplines, they are expected to study this text. It is not the only text. There are four, five options that can be very easily verified by you. And then the question was that first thing was at that time it was a rude shock. There were very serious resolutions, there were many protest letters, etc. And, in all fairness, let's be very clear, nobody knows who those experts are. And this was done by the university, decided who to select. What is interesting is that the last meeting that you are referring to, there was apparently, the reports of the four referees, let's say, were tabled. And three of the historians, whoever they are, and not only thought that this is a very interesting text and it should be retained, but more significantly, there was, there are historians and historians, and if you want to play foul, there are many ways of doing it, and I think it would be, something that is very interesting to actually note, because I have not seen the reports, but I have been told that the fourth historian, whoever she or he is, suggested that this, this text is very interesting and it should be retained, but it can be taken as a serious text, sorry, not retained, but it can hurt the sentiments of people who are young, and to hide behind all that, the suggestion apparently is to include some text or some material written by R.S. Sharma and Romila Thapar. Now, you see, obviously, as I told you, this whole thing is mischievous. It's very unfair to have a meeting where, in the name of democracy, people who have no idea about either the text or Ramanujan or his works or his contributions are allowed to discuss. And what is very remarkable is that the whole process of the debate, which apparently democratic debate, I was told, lasted for 4 hours, over which it was not a question of history, the meaning of rationality, science, the question of diversities of our very rich cultural heritage, our rich pluralistic past, our as in not necessarily Indian, but as Ramayana, this text has references to what could be called Near East, Thailand, Cambodia, and how people relate to the Ramayana there. And in the name of sentiments being hurt, a text which is an optional text is dropped. And it was very interesting that along with the university establishment, The Congress official, the Congress unofficial, and the BJP were on one side, and there were nine people who were defending the fact that this, you know, please don't do this. And the head of the department pleaded, saying that, you know, Supreme Court has not told us to drop or accept this, but Supreme Court has told us to take opinions, and let us go back and tell the court that, you know, these are the opinions, and you know, let us look at it in this way, that, you know, give us some you know, ways in which, I mean, let it be discussed, debated, and maybe it can go to the history department. Various things we can also add. So I was talking like a scientist. I would argue that, you know, you've had Galileo, and you've known the experience when Newton discovered gravity on the basis of that apple falling. You know, maybe you know, if the Academy Council was sitting on judgment, they would have, you know, persecuted Newton like Galileo was. So that's how the story is. What is also very encouraging is, I must add, that the Sanskrit department head supported the history head. Okay. And he was among those nine people. And the argument given was very interesting. The argument given was that it's very rational and very scientific argument. This is all that I have heard. I mean, I have not, obviously, I don't sit in that body. So I've been told that the Sanskrit department head argued that, you know, we teach things where we discuss, you know, parts of the female body, female sexuality, and various other complicated things which might appear very difficult to teach. And we teach them, and what is so terrible about it? And this has been done by people who obviously are like us teachers. They must have looked at all the pros and cons and decided to take something, and it's an option. So similarly the Punjabi department head and the commerce department head, extremely rational. I mean, the arguments being in the same genre, that, you know, I mean, after all, some people have decided to offer this as one of the four or five texts, and let that be. I mean, why do we want to interfere? So this is, you know, I mean, I don't want to use strong words, but, well, I mean, this is obviously reminiscent of, as I said, of this whole idea of pushing in an agenda which has no academic standing, which is irrational, which goes against the very basic sort of idea of what could be called India.
So do you think actually that the central point of debate is not really the procedural lapses, but the fact that the multiplicity of views or points of view, it's an attack on that?
It's an attack on the very fabric of, it's an anti-national act, I'll argue, but because you are, you know, not acknowledging that there is something called South India. You know, it's not a question of, you know, I mean, a text is completely harmless. I mean, I'll appeal to all these people who are so angry, including the ABBP students and everybody who supports it also. This idea that this text should be there, to ever look at this text, you know, I mean, in fact, if I'm not wrong, I've read it many times, but most probably it starts by saying 300 Ramayans or 1000. In fact, I'll add, I mean, a million Ramayanas, because you see, I mean, I keep on giving this example. I mean, in Orissa, if you actually check the, you know, the different districts, we call them in India, there are different districts every state has. I know at least there are 3-4 Ayodhyas. In Odia we call it Ayodhya, which becomes Ayodhya as you come to. I mean, there itself is the plurality of how you pronounce a name. You call it Rama, but I will call it Rama. You know, I mean, this itself shows the type of what I am trying to get at, which is that you cannot just have one version of anything. I mean, beyond sciences, in social science, to imagine that you discuss something without having the possibility of debating that basically means that you are looking at zombieizing the whole mind. And I think this is tying up with that whole neoliberal thinking process, where you are supposed to be dumb creatures, you are not supposed to question anything.
If you could just talk about the text, because it's a different kind of a genre that is there, and why is this particular text, in your opinion, I mean, though I understand that one has to go beyond it, but still coming back to the text, do you think that there's some importance that we can attach to the text per se in this particular case?
The significance of the text is purely related to the fact that it's a brilliant mind, and nothing else. And the brilliant mind obviously is trying to, you know, take you through a journey. You know, it's hardly 40, I'm so sorry, I mean, I'm very bad with numbers, maybe 40, 45 pages. You know, it's trying to take you through a journey where maybe, I don't know, I mean, it appears as if he is also thinking as he's writing. It's not just, you know, an attempt to communicate something in a very, you know, formal academic way, because you see the type of references, the way he moves from, he talks about Tulsidas, he talks about so many other Ramayans. And, you know, for example, we all know very well that there are traditions where Rama and Sita, are brothers and sisters. It's so interesting. And what is so wrong about it? I mean, it's there. I mean, you can't just, you can't murder me because I am saying that Odisha has three Ayodhyas. It's not my fault. I mean, at the same time, I wish that certain things are done in the way that people read things. I remember when Tamas, that was the Janata Party regime, maybe much before your birth, or maybe you are not, or you are just born. I remember that very classic statement of Advani. He was the information minister, and that's where that's where the debate focused for some time, saying that I have not read Tamas. I won't read Tamas, but it should be banned. I mean, I thought India had traveled, quite a bit from that phase. But at least Delhi University shows that, we're going back to the period when I'm talking about Advani's famous statements.
But I think out of all this, an important question arises, that why history as a subject has always been attacked by the right wing. Be it during the NDA government, we had this whole revision of textbooks where history and myth got completely, they were combined in a sense. What do you think is that importance of history where it comes under attack?
It's not India only. If you look at German fascism, if you look at Hitler's rise, and if you look at, it is, I think, a part of that whole process, because this is a discipline. And let's be very clear, I take pride in the fact that Indian history, the way things stand today, it's a very, very developed history world we have, and we have fascinating scholars. Today the type of work that historians work on, even 5-10 years back, you would not imagine that somebody would work on a little lunatic asylum, that somebody would work on for example, Indian History Congress, if you look at the papers. If you are a really good historian, a good historian will definitely have certain very basic beliefs, accepting liberalism as a very major feature.
Could this also be like this fear of history? Also, because a community finds its identity, or there is always an attempt to link a community's identity to the past, and therefore history as a discipline becomes important to attack in.
Anybody who has certain very basic understanding of the rhythms of history will obviously like to question that very feature, that how can you identify anything with a particular community or a particular religion or a particular language, and we look at interactions. I mean, the very basic thing is that imagine how the world would have been if you had one version of Ramayana. It would be terrible. I mean, what would we discuss then? History would, it would be the end of history, because there is nothing to debate. If we all of us had one interpretation of how human beings came to this planet, how they emerged or whatever, evolved, imagine how horrible it would be. And you can put it this way, that maybe that there is this tremendous fear and insecurity with this discipline, because this discipline actually subverts very basic agendas or programs that some of these people might try to propagate.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. It was an enlightening discussion.